Hello students, I am going to teach in today's lecture the Bragg and Cat notation in quantum mechanics, how to represent the state function in quantum mechanics. In quantum mechanics, the state of system is described by a state function that is denoted by this psi, and this notation is known as the Cat notation. And this complex conjugate of this wave function is represented by the Bragg notation, like this 0, 1 state, half state. These are the Cat representation, and the 0, this 0, 1 half, and these are the Bragg notation in the quantum mechanics. So the wave function in quantum mechanics tells everything about the system. That means if you know the present wave function at time t, then you can determine anything after the time t. And like this, this electron state can be represented by this Cat notation, atom and photon. Everything can be represented by this Cat notation. Normally we know in the vectors that a vector is represented by this format. That is, b is equal to 1 0 0 3 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. So here 0, 3, 2 are the coefficient. So this vector can be represented by 2 3 0. So this is the column entry. Okay, the corresponding Bragg notation or the row vectors can be obtained by this v. So that means the overall conclusion of this Cat notation, that means Cat vectors are corresponding to the column vectors and the Bragg vectors are corresponding to the row vectors. If you need the column vectors, then you can get the row vectors with the help of column vectors. Column vectors and the row vectors are complex conjugate to each other. So the wave function in quantum mechanics is a vector, just not like in the space, but it is a spatial vector, that is an abstract mathematical thing which is called the Hilbert space. So the difference between the vector space is that the coefficient in quantum mechanics, these coefficient 2, 3, 0, this is in the classical mechanics, they are the real in classical mechanics, but in quantum mechanics they are not real, they are the complex numbers. So this is the basic difference between the classical mechanics and the quantum mechanics wave function. So they have in general a non-zero imaginary part. These numbers may be conjugated, which is denoted by, suppose this is z is a complex number, x is x plus i y, so x is the real and i y. In classical mechanics the coefficient are the real, that means there is no imaginary part. The imaginary part is zero in classical mechanics, but in case of the quantum mechanics, this real part, imaginary part is non-zero. So the complex conjugate of this z can be represented by z star is equal to x minus i y. So that means we only change this I to minus I by taking the complex conjugate. So this is known as the complex conjugate. So so complex number make quantum mechanics different from ordinary math. But the biggest difference is just the notation. In quantum mechanics, we don't write vector with an arrow. Instead, we write them with these funny brackets. That is, these column vectors can be represented by a11 0 0 a20 0 1 0 a30 0 0 1. So here a1, a2, a3 are the complex numbers. They are not real. And here 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 are known as the basis vectors. So basis vectors are those which has the 0 entry except one entry is 1. So the if you want to calculate the Bragg vectors corresponding to this psi, then you just convert this into the row vectors. That means a1, a2, a3 is the column vectors, and a1 star, a2 star, a3 star is the row vectors corresponding to this column vectors. So this is the row vector, and this notation was the idea of the Paul Dirac, and it is known as the bracket notation. Thanking you in next